I got one for you. What do you call it when one chickpea murders another? Homicide. I'm Sean Torbati, and in 2 minutes, I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know about the vegan diet. What it is, how it works, its pros and cons, and what the science has to say about it. So let's get started. The vegan diet is a nutrition approach based on the overall lifestyle of consuming no animal products. There are a lot of potential reasons for going vegan, but for this video, we'll put aside the ethical implications and focus on the nuts and bolts of the actual vegan diet. Now, to start a vegan diet, just take a look at what you're eating. If any of it contains meat, fish, cheese, milk, or eggs, it's a no-go. But pretty much everything else is fair game. Vegan diets are often talked about as boring or lacking variety, but the fact is there are literally tens of thousands of edible plant species and an infinite number of meals that can be made from them, so this isn't really a problem. The vegan diet we typically see in practice is high carbohydrate, low fat, and low protein, but the amount of each macronutrient can be manipulated with more precise planning. There are a lot of positives to going vegan. Eating more fruits and veggies means you'll see a significant increase in phytonutrients and antioxidants, which can lower your risks for many diseases and extend your lifespan. Many people do also lose weight when switching to a vegan diet, which I attribute to an increase in fiber, a decrease in fat intake, and often a decrease in overall calories. Now, there are a couple of potential drawbacks to the vegan diet. If you are accustomed to eating meat or other animal products, I particularly find this to be the case with dairy, it can be quite difficult to cut them out of your diet. Also, there are certain nutrients that are just easier to obtain or absorb from animal products. This includes protein, iron, vitamin B12, DHA, and a few others. The good news, however, is that vegans can get all of these nutrients through diet or supplementation. It just requires a little more planning. Now, what does the science have to say about it? Well, there's plenty of debate right now in the scientific community as to whether or not the vegan diet is optimal for health or if it's even better than other diet forms that include animal product. We do, however, have great evidence to support that the vegan diet can offer a wide range of health benefits, such as weight loss, lower blood pressure and cholesterol, and even a longer lifespan. Now, with that said, science won't be the starting point for most people's decision to go vegan. If you have a desire to reduce or remove animal product from your lifestyle, the vegan diet can help you do just that. My biggest recommendation is to make sure you eat a large variety of foods and pay attention to consume sources of all the nutrients I mentioned earlier. If you're going to try a vegan diet, or if you're already following one, comment below and let me know how you like it. Remember, I'm always here to help. Thanks for watching. The one thing I want to leave you guys with is that the vegan diet does not have to be boring. I have two of my favorite dishes right here, buffalo cauliflower and coconut ceviche. These are two things you typically would see with an animal protein base, but they're done in a vegan format. I've been dying to eat these and I'm gonna get to that in a second, but I wanna remind you to stay tuned for my next video. It will be on the opposite of the vegan diet, the carnivore diet, the all meat diet. Don't miss that video. I'm gonna get to eating this.